Welcome to this second tutorial under Matricep. So, as you all you have seen, I post which I'm going to continue from multiplication of matrices. Okay, so for us to understand what is, you can multiply matrices that have got different order or instance. You can have a matrix that is a 2 by 2, for instance 1, 4, and also another matrix that has a 3, 2. So what you need to understand here is that when I want to multiply A and B, there is only one condition that you need to follow, and this condition should be that the number of columns in this matrix A should be equal, that is the number of rows in this matrix B. So unlike for addition and subtraction, you need to have obviously the same order that are contained in different matrix, but for multiplication you have to be very careful. Okay, so let's have an example. Now in this example I'm going to use A and B. So I'm going to have A, find number 1, A, B, number 2, B, A. So what we have down here is you have got A multiplied by B, B multiplied by A. So before we get to multiply these two matrices, first of all let's find out the orders. Okay, so the orders actually means that the number of rows and the number of columns of the elements, or rather the entries. So in A we have got, you can see that when you are giving out the order you need to start by counting the number of rows. For instance, so this is 1, 2, so we have got 2 by, then this one is also 1, 2, so I've got 2 by 2. And then now let's also find out what is the order of matrix B. So for B, you have 1, so I've got 1 row by 1, 2, so I've got 2. So now is it possible that we can multiply the two matrices? So let's see here what actually you need to follow so that you can multiply two matrices. So if you have got A times B, so what you're saying is that this is going to have 1 by 2. So the number of columns in the first matrix should be equal to the number of rows in the second matrix, meaning that these two are not equal. Okay, therefore A multiplied by B is not possible. Okay, so let's see about B multiplied by A. So B multiplied by A is possible because we have swapped the two matrices, or we have done the pre-multiplication. This one is post-multiplication. So we have started with B and then ended with A. So this is not possible, or you just write the word undefined. So undefined. So for b times a, this is possible. So we are going to do a quick multiplication. We have that was okay. Let me just put another 2 1 0 and then 3 2. Okay. So now the way you multiply is row into column, then row into column. Okay. Now before you multiply, you have to understand that this is a 2 by 2. Then this is also what made a mistake. Okay, we start with this one. Then that was 3 2 1 0. Okay. So this is a 1 by 2, then this is 2 by 2. So what you need to understand is that these are the same. Okay? So therefore what you do is row into column. So we are going to have 3 multiplied by 2 plus 2 times 2. Then you leave a space. Then you come to this column. 3 times 1 plus 2 times 0. Since you only have one row but two columns. Okay? So our answer should have the order of these last numbers. So our answer should be 1 by 2. 1 by 2. Okay? Okay, so just to do that, 3 times, this is 6 plus, this is 4, this is 3 plus, this is 0. So we have, that is 10, that is 2. So if you want to confirm the answer from the way we arrange the order, is that we said that our answer should have 1 by 2. So this is one row, which is 1 by 2 columns. Okay? So now, after we understand the way we multiply matrices, now the last part that we need to do is okay, so let's have how do we find the determinant? Okay. Now at this level, the determinant can only be solved for a 2 by 2 matrix. So only for a 2 by 2 matrix. Okay. So example, finding given that A equals to 2, 3, 4, 5. So find determinant, or find determinant of A. Okay. So what you need to understand is that when you find the determinant, is that you have to understand that within this matrix you have got what is known as the major diagonal and the minor diagonal. So the determinant is given by A equals to major diagonal, which is 2 multiplied by 5, and B minus. So always the main sign here is that you put a minus within 3 times 4. Now that is actually makes it simple. So 2 by 5 it's 10 minus 3 by 4 it is 12. So therefore what you do is 10 minus 12 you get negative 2. So That is how simple it is to find the determinant. Therefore, from the determinant now, we can be asked to find what is the index of the same matrix A. So now, in conclusion, let's end with how can you find the inverse of a matrix which is a 2x2.
Okay.
Therefore, so let's find the inverse. Find the inverse of matrix A. Now the symbol for inverse is given by O. A to the power negative 1. So anything raised to the A to the power negative 1 simply means that you are finding the inverse. So therefore, you cannot find the inverse if you don't have the determinant. So first of all, the first step is you need to find the determinant and then come to find the inverse. Therefore, A to the power negative 1, so that is a symbol for inverse, equals to 1 over the determinant that we have found, which is negative 2. So over negative 2 multiplied by the original matrix. But only you just need to modify a little bit, okay? So modification in the inverse to the original matrix is that you change the entries in the major diagonal, you swap them, and then the entries in the minor diagonal, you give them different signs. For instance, since they are positive and the other one is positive, so we are going to give them the negatives as simple as that. So 5 will go there. So 5, let me just use a different marker. So 5 there, and then 2 comes here, and then 3 will have negative, as well as 4 will have negative. You can end there, but of course you can now further start multiplying the number which is outside here. You start multiplying with each entry in the matrix, just to show the examiner that you know how to further multiply. Therefore, just to multiply 1 over negative 2, which is negative half, with every single element. So you have A inverse equals to half times 5. You get 5 over negative 2 or negative 5 over 2. Half times negative 4. So the negative and the negative will cancel. So this means that we have 1 over negative 2 times negative 4. So 2 there it's 1, 2 there it's 2. Then the multiply by 3. So remember, the negative and the negative is cancelled. So we have 3 over 2. And then half multiply by 2. Now this is negative half multiply by, that is 2. Multiply by 2, so this is negative 2 over 2, so 1, and that is how you just go about multiplication of matrices.